What's up, guys? It's Oblivious Gamer here, and today I wanted to give my impressions regarding a game that I have been playing that recently came out, and so far I have been enjoying. The game is Death End Request 2, which is a role-playing game developed by Compile Heart and Idea Factory. It is described as a horror RPG, and I would add that it has a visual novel aspect, and there's also a collaboration with Corpse Party Scenario Writer. It is a sequel to Death End Request. It serves as a continuity for the first game, however, the sequel has a different protagonist and place. Granted, you will meet some of the characters of the first game, but I don't necessarily feel you need to play the first one to jump and play this game. Granted, as when it comes to any series, I would say if you can play the first game, I would recommend it. It is a very fun game, but at least as far as I have played, I don't feel it is needed if you just want to jump into the second one. The version I play is the PC one, which came out August 18th. I got the game for $39.99 since they have an offer running until August 25th, where the game has a 20% discount. This game follows Mai Toyama as she's trying to search for her sister Sanae in a mysterious and quiet lake town known as Lee Shohara. As you play the game, you will be learning about Mai, her past, her family, and why is she in this town searching for her sister. Along the way, she will meet characters who she will befriend, such as Rotten Dollheart, known as Roddy, and Liliana Pinata. Both of these characters you will be able to control during battle and will be helping Mai as she tries to find clues as to where is her sister. At the same time, they will be discovering that something is off with the town and the orphanage that they are staying. Now, I gotta say, I am really enjoying this story. They really try to play in some of the horror aspects. Granted, it is not too much. Like, you really don't see anything that would be bloody or gruesome. Though, as a personal opinion, I think there are moments that would have benefited if they would have been more open to showcase some more gruesome moments than just describing them. I like how they have like this pseudo day and night system, is how I would describe it, where during the day, the game is visual novel style where you'll be talking and interacting with different characters, learning more about them and the town, with many showing that there are more than what meets the eyes. For gameplay, as I mentioned, this game has like a pseudo day and night mode. During the day, it's more like a visual novel where you will get to interact and talk with people around, sometimes learning more about them and the town. And then during the night, it turns into an RPG where you will be exploring, fighting different creatures, and of course, completing missions. During the RPG part, you will be able to explore different areas, and there's a decent amount to explore to find different chests with loot. Also, just a heads up, when it comes to the environment, it just looks okay. Like, don't expect this to look graphically insane or have like interesting points to remember when it comes to the environment. Also, you will be engaging with many of the creatures of the night that you will encounter. And I have to say, I love fighting opponents. One thing to note is, as you are exploring, you are being chased by a shadow figure that from time to time, they will appear and will try to chase you. And obviously, if you manage to encounter them, like try to like attack them or engage with them, it's game over. So obviously, the best thing to do is just to run away. Granted, the mechanic is not annoying since it's super easy to evade them just by running away, or even if you engage an enemy, by the time you finish that engagement, the shadow figure is gone. I think it's a nice mechanic, but for me, it just feels it's too easy to avoid him. Maybe it's done that way to prevent the mechanic from being too annoying. Now, this game also brought a mechanic back from the first game called the knockback mechanic, which is really fun to do, where when using certain amount of attacks or commands, it will initiate a knockback where the character will smack the enemies and push them back, some flying away super far and bouncing with each other that will cause damage. Another thing, if an enemy is knocked into an ally, they may perform a knock blow action, which allows them to strike the incoming foe for a devastating combo. Another thing to note is performing a knockback will help increase your XP bonus. So the more you attack the enemy, and obviously with the help of the knockback mechanic, the higher the XP you will gain. I think it's a nice incentive to try to use this mechanic. And it's a fun mechanic that is not very typical, you know, for your turn-based RPG. There are also circles on the floor, which are called curse bugs, when you engage an enemy. Some of these circles can provide buffs, such as attack buffs, defense buff, can recover health. Also, all of the characters have a percentage meter. that increases every time you go over the curse box or get attacked by an enemy. Once the percentage reaches 80%, the character enters in a power-up state called glitch mode, where they are buffed up and have access to some new moves which look very cool. I love doing them whenever I can. Also, apart from leveling up and learning new skills, sometimes when you perform some skills in a specific order, you will learn new skills. I think it's a very cool system because it gives you an incentive to try different combinations of skills to see if you can unlock a new one. Personally, I really enjoyed the combat, so grinding for me isn't a big deal. However, if it is for you, there is an option to just auto battle so you don't have to worry about anything. If you end up finding the battles to be annoying, because again, you will encounter a lot of these monsters. As with any RPG, there is gear, and of course you will be spending time trying to find some good gear for your characters. Granted, there is a shop where you can buy gear. However, so far I haven't found good things in the shop. Most of the good gear I have has come from finding them in the chest. I'm really surprised how much I'm enjoying the game. The game also has English voice acting, and I really like the voice acting in this game. And this is coming from somebody who usually just turns the Japanese voice acting and plays with subs. So I was really surprised how I ended up liking it.
I won't let you. I won't let you!
Hey.
My father froze in terror. I stood on top of his stomach, lifting the hatchet in my hand.
Hey!
Elstrain. Lord, I thank you.
What's up with Elstrain?
It's a religion followed by everyone in town. With his undying love, we are guided and protected from evil.
I see.
You didn't eat dinner last night. You must be starving. Want my egg?
No. I have a small appetite.
I think for the price, it's a really fun visual novel with RPG elements and of course the horror aspects. It can be really fun in trying to figure out the mystery of Li Shuhara and, you know, the characters. I think it's a nice hook, at least for me, and I'm really curious to find out more. I can definitely recommend this game to any RPG fans. Hell, I would even recommend it to those that are fond with visual novels, because I think the story can be fun and has an interesting plot, and the gameplay is just really fun with the knockback mechanic and just having fun with the characters. So this is a game, if you haven't heard of it, I think you definitely should check it out. You won't regret it, I'm telling you. So yeah guys, what are your thoughts on the game? Have you tried it out? This has been Oblivious Gamer, and I hope you'll have a wonderful day or night wherever you are.